हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज निशा वासुदेवा फ्रॉम आरए कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी जयपुर। टुडे वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक रिड्यूसिबिलिटी एंड सेटिस्फिएबिलिटी इन द एनपी कंप्लीट प्रॉब्लम। दिस इज अ टॉपिक फ्रॉम द थ्योरी ऑफ कंप्यूटेशन। देन फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट डिसीजन वर्सेस ऑप्टिमाइजेशन प्रॉब्लम। दैट मीन्स देर आर नंबर ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स आर एग्जिस्ट लाइक पी एन पी एन पी कंप्लीट एन पी हार्ड। देन वट इज द डिसीजन प्रॉब्लम एंड वट इज द ऑप्टिमाइजेशन प्रॉब्लम। In the decision problem, we have only take the decision. Either this solution have any solution or not. But whereas in the case of optimization problem, we have to find one optimal solution for particular problem in the polynomial time. So in the decision problem, we have find only the decision, yes or no, in the polynomial time. Whereas in the optimization problem, we have to find the optimal solution in a given time or in the polynomial time. Next, what is reduction? That topic is also known as reducibility in the problem. In this, we reduce one problem into the another problem and we take the decision basis on this. If one problem is solved in the polynomial time, then the another problem is also solved in the polynomial time. That is the concept of reduction. So we have assume L1 and L2, that be the two decision problem. Assume there is a two algorithm also exist, A2, that solve the problem L2. That says if y is the input for L2, then the algorithm A2 will answer yes or no, depending upon whether y belongs to L2 or not. The idea is to find a transformation from L1 to L2 so that if the algorithm A2 can be the part of algorithm A1 to solve L1. We can show this diagrammatically. In this diagram or in this picture, first we take, this is the complete algorithm, that is algorithm for L1. This L1 is applied after L2 applied. That means first this take the input L2, apply the algorithm, then it gives one answer, or this is a decision problem, answer is yes or no. On this answer value, we again apply this algorithm L1 and we find the answer yes or no. That means if L2 have the yes answer, then L1 is also have the yes answer, because L1 reduced into L2 problem and L2 reduced the problem into L1 problem. This is the concept of reducibility. Next, what is satisfiability? Satisfiability means we have a number of conditions for this and a number of tuples for this, and the condition is satisfied and this formula gives same result. So for proving this, there are number of Boolean variables are exist like x1, x2, x3, xn. And this xi bar denotes a relation of xi, that means there are the number of relation between the elements. A literal cell is either a variable or its negation. A formula in the propositional calculus is an expression that can be constructed using the literals and the operators. There are number of operators are working like AND or OR. Or a clause is a formula with at least one positive literals. The satisfiability problem is to determine if the formula is true or false for some assignment of truth value or the false value to the variable. We already study how the propositional table work in this AND or operators are present. We apply in this on the Boolean variables to find the answer is true or false. This is the two steps we are doing in the case of satisfiability. It is easy to obtain a polynomial time non-deterministic algorithm that terminates successfully if and only if a given propositional formula is satisfiable. Non-deterministic means for one value we have number of options for this, so we can find a very easily solution of we can say this is the optimal solution in the optimal polynomial time. So if one condition is satisfiable, then other is also satisfiable. Number two is such an algorithm could proceed by simply choosing one of the 2n possible assignment of the truth value. This 2n means there are number of guesses value are present. If n is equals to 5, then 2 to the power 5, that means 32 number of possible values are present. From these 32 tuples, we can choose any of the value and verify that result is true or not. Next, what is the satisfiability problem? We can explain by an example. If the number of tuples are present or Boolean variables are present like x1, x2, x3, we apply any operator AND or NOT. Number of operators are present, this give the, we assign the value false, and this x3 assign the value t means true, f means false. We'll make the above formula true. That means if we write this not x1, not x2, x3 represent, if x1 is equals to false, x2 is equals to false, x3 is equals to true, and we apply the negation of this, that means x1 value is true and x2 value is also true, whereas x3 is true. Next, if there is at least one assignment which satisfies formula, then we can say this formula is satisfiable, otherwise it is unsatisfiable. That means if we are given some value true false, if one formula is satisfied that condition, then other formula is also satisfy this condition. This is the formula like x1 union x2 and x1 not sorry union not x2 and not x1, that is a complement of x1 or x2, and number of operations are present here, number of examples are present. This is the definition of the satisfiability problem. For a given Boolean formula, determine whether this formula is satisfiable or not. So number of literals, number of clauses are present. So a literal xi or not of xi, a clause x1 union x2 union not of x3, that is any of the clause, or we can say this is a class c1, c2, c3, number of clauses are present. Number 3 is a formula that is a conjugative normal form, jisko hum bolte hain CNF form, that is the C1 and C2 and number of conjugated forms are present. Next one is a Cook's theorem. This Cook is a Stephen Cook is the name of the scientist who invent this, and he gives the statement that the circuit satisfiability problem is anti-hard. So we have to prove one of the circuits. Circuit means there is a number of loops are present, the starting and the ending vertex, this is same. That is, we have to prove that this circuit satisfiability is anti-hard. So for this, finally a problem is NP-complete if it is both NP-hard. NP-hard means we have only reduced the problem into some another problem, but for the NP-complete we have two steps for this. As we already studied, we have to first prove this is NP-hard, second we have to prove this is and is in NP, so this is NP-complete. So for the NP-hard we just only prove this is only reduction problem, or we can reduce this problem into the another problem in the polynomial time. So proof of this is to show that this set is the NP-hard. Set means this is the satisfiability problem. We have to give a reduction from a known NP-hard problem. The only problem we know that this is NP-hard, so this is circuit satisfiability, because according to the Cook's, the circuit satisfiability problem is a NP-hard problem. Then start from this and we connect all the problem from circuit satisfiability to set, set to next problem and so on. So let's start there. Given a Boolean circuit, we can transform it into a Boolean formula by creating new output variable for each gate and then just writing down the list of gates separated by the AND. For example, we could transform the example circuit into the formula as follows. This is the circuit is present. In this AND or NOT, all the gates are present. This is the input value x1, x2. We can see this. This y8, that is the final output. So this is a Boolean circuit and we apply some of the operations on this, that is a node and or gates, and we can find the final output, that is the y8. Next, now the original circuit is satisfiable if and only if the resulting formula is satisfiable. If and only if the resulting formula is satisfiable means if original circuit satisfy all the conditions, then the y8 is also satisfy all the conditions. So for a given a satisfiability or satisfy input to the circuit, we can get a satisfy assignment for the formula by computing the output for every gate. For every gate, we get some output value. This is also satisfy the condition of satisfiability. Given a satisfy assignment for the formula, we can get a satisfy input to the circuit by just ignoring the gate variable yi. Second is, we can transform any Boolean circuit into the formula in the linear time using the depth first search. That means using any of the searching algorithm, we can reduce one of the circuit into the another in the polynomial time. So this is the concept of reducibility. That means we have the polynomial time reduction from the circuit satisfiability to the set. This is a representation of this Boolean circuit in the polynomial time converted into the Boolean formula, and we applying the set, that is a satisfiability problem, that is true or false. This gives the answer, that is in the polynomial time, so we can say that this is NP-hard problem, or we can reduce this problem. Same for this, the reduction implies that we had the polynomial time algorithm for set, then we had a polynomial time for the circuit satisfiability. That means this set is a NP-hard we have proved that this set is a NP hard. But if we want this is NP complete, then we have to prove this is in the NP. So for proving this, a Boolean formula is satisfiable, we only have to specify an assignment to the variable that make the formula true. That means we have to take number of Boolean variables with us, number of operators and or not, and we have to find if this give the answer in the polynomial time or in the linear time by reading the formula from left to right, evaluating as we go. So set is also in NP. If this is in NP and this is NP hard, so we can say this is NP complete. So we can say that this set problem is the NP complete problem. Next, what is the consecutive normal forms? These are known as CNF forms. In this, the number of variables, or we can say Boolean variables, are present. These are represented by normal x or node, that is known as negated Boolean variable, and number of classes or clauses are present in the several literals that is connected to with this our operator. For example, x union y union not z. A Boolean formula is in conjugated form if it is made of the number of classes with this sign. That means all the variables, number of formulas exist, but in between we have using this AND operator. So we can see that this is in the CNF form. Next, we have to prove this CNF set is a NP complete. We already know that set is a NP complete problem. Now we have to prove this CNF with set, that is a NP complete. And what is CNF? We already studied CNF means we have number of variables with the AND or operators, then we apply this formula for this. So a Boolean formula is a CNF formula if it is a formula in the consecutive normal form. Let CNF set be a language, that is satisfiable language. So we have to prove this is NP complete. For this completeness, first we have to prove this is in the NP. Second, we have to reduce this problem into CNF set, that means this is NP hard problem. Because of the Cook's theorem, we can say that this set is the NP complete problem. If this is NP complete problem and we in the set problem we also take the number of variables, so because set is NP complete, then we can say that this CNF set is also NP complete. Now we have to prove 3 set is a NP complete. 3 set means in the CNF formula the maximum number of Boolean variables are 3, not more than 3. So that's why this is known as 3 set problem. A Boolean formula is in the 3 CNF formula if it is a formula in the conjugative normal form and every clause have exactly 3 literals or 3 Boolean variables. That means if it has 3 variables and then we have to prove this is NP complete, the same step we follow. First we prove this is NP hard, second we prove this is in the NP. To show this, the proof of this is to show 3 set is NP complete, we have 2 things to done. Show 3 set is in the NP. Second, show that the every language is an NP in the polynomial time reducible to the 3 set. That means we have to reduce this problem in the polynomial time to the set problem. So we know already set is NP complete. Again, we link these two problems. Set is NP complete problem. So 3 set is also NP complete problem. So to reduce 3 CNF set to 3 set, that means set is related to 3 CNF set and 3 CNF set is also NP complete, and we link CNF set to 3 set, that means this is also reduction process, set to CNF set and set now to 3 set. That means we convert CNF formula F into 3 CNF formula with F is satisfiable. That means because CNF set is satisfiable, so 3 set is also satisfiable. That means we reduce the problem in a hierarchical manner. Set to 3 CR. First we start from set to CNF set, now to 3 set. That means there is a linking between the process. So firstly, let C1, C2, CK, there are number of classes are present. The formula contain maximum of 3 variables. So F is a satisfiable problem that have 3 CNF formula, just why F dash to be F. Otherwise, the only reason why F is not 3 NF formula R means if it does not contain exactly 3 value, that problem is not considered in the 3 set problem. And some clause have less than 3 variables, some clause have more than 3 variables. If number of classes are present, those problem who have number of variable are less than 3 or more than 3, these all classes are discarded in this case. So for each class which have only 3 variable are considered for this problem, and we reduce the problem into CNF set problem. Then because CNF set problem is satisfiable and reducible to set problem, and CNF set is NP complete, that's why we can say that 3 set is also NP complete. So in this we can say if F dash is satisfiable, the value of L1 must be 1. We can write this formula L1 union L1 for each clause. They have two literals, say L1 union L2, we change into L1 L2 L1, thus F is satisfiable if the value must be 1. Same for this, the number of variable are 3, not more than 3, we can get the value 1 for the satisfiability. Finally, each class have the 3 literals and all the classes are satisfiable, so whole the problem is satisfiable. That means 3 set, that is NP complete. There are number of basic steps for proving the NP complete, as we already discussed. For proving NP complete, we prove set is NP complete. Next we prove CNF, that is a CNF set is NP complete. Next we prove 3 set is NP complete, that means all the problem linked to next problem. So we generalize this process, set is NP complete. Next 3 CNF set is reduced into set. Click problem that reduces into 3 CNF sets. Same process follow for the all problem. All the problem are linking to each other. There is a hierarchical order for this. Because first problem is NP complete, so we reduce all the problem into sets. So all the problem is also NP complete. So this is the complete concept for proving the NP complete. There are first we do the reducibility on the basis of satisfiability. First we satisfy the formula, then we reduce this into the another problem, and if the basic problem is NP complete, then we can say that the another problem is also NP complete. This reducibility and satisfiability, that is a major part of the NP complete problem. Thank you.